So now we go to the green field, which is more interesting. So there are like new technology that hasn't been there before. So that's a sweet spot for hyperscalers because they can easily go in, show their capabilities, commit, and acquire. One of them is a telco edge and the enterprise edge. So they are very competent when they offer, for example, edge in a box. You will see in the next slide that, for example, Microsoft can come to you and tell you, I can give you a full 5G core with IoT application in a box. And you can start lead that directly to an enterprise customer. This is like a very well-known advantage of the hyperscaler. They can do that in a box and they ship it to you the same way they ship their enterprise service to their customers. In telco edge, and I'm here saying telco edge to refer to, for example, the O-RAN stuff and the 5G core. If you search in Google now, you find that, for example, Google, the searching engine, you find, for example, that there are a lot of attention now being given from hyperscalers to the O-RAN in particular. Google has recently joined the TIP, sorry, the O-RAN Alliance. AWS showed in the MWC the onboarding of, I think, Altiostar, and they partnered with Dish, the operator in USA, to onboard the O-RAN on AWS, on the Outpost. Same for Microsoft. So they are all focusing to get in this market and provide a full solution on the edge to the mobile operators. The innovative telco clouds, these are like the telco cloud that's hosting microservice containers, and that's where the hyperscalers are focusing to give you the environment and the platform as a service to host your 5G applications and your stuff. And for sure, the most suitable coupling comes with a greenfield operators. And you also, the case of Dish in the US. So Dish has picked AWS to be the cloud platform hosting all their core and edge and O-RAN stuff, entertaining like functions from Nokia, if I remember well. So greenfield operators, they go for the hyperscalers, and there is a point here. And we will see that in the advantages of the hyperscaler and the threats. These new operators, they prefer to go to OpEx model rather than CapEx model. And I'll explain that. So the CapEx model, and that's the typical model that we are following in the traditional procurement cycle of the mobile operator, that you do investment, you save budget, you buy software, you buy hardware, you put a lot of CapEx, and then you do your best to get revenue out of the services coming from this investment. So that's a CapEx model. But if you go to hyperscaler, for example, you switch, I wouldn't say totally, but to a big extent, to an OpEx model. You go to a subscription-based. So everything is hosted on cloud on AWS. You get more customers, you get more revenue, you pay you pay to AWS. But if you don't get traffic, so you get minimal consumption, minimal customers, then also you pay AWS a little bit. So it's like pay as you go. And that's a model somehow preferred by the new operators, new MVNOs, not to put a huge investment, not to put huge CapEx thing, but rather focus on OpEx model. And what you can see here, I will end with this one. That's the spanning between the brownfield and greenfield, something called hybrid and multi-cloud governance. When you start to welcome hyperscalers, you find that as a CSP, you end up with multiple cloud stacks. I have an IT cloud on-prem. I have an Azure. Maybe I have an AWS. I have a telco cloud. So how can I govern? How can I manage or orchestrate all these clouds? There are some solutions provided by the hyperscalers to give this kind of capability. And I'll not talk about product, but I'll mention Microsoft Arc, for example. And Arc is some sort of enhancement of the existing arm of Microsoft. So it allows you to manage multiple clouds, multiple environments like VM-based Kubernetes and Azure. So if you have this kind of framework, you'll be able to manage multi-clouds on your environment.